And now we would like to dig really deep into technology. And I got a technology expert with me. Karsten, you're from our Munich office, an application specialist. And you brought us a setup, a technical setup. So Karsten, what do we see here?
Yeah, so this technical setup is here to demonstrate the capability of EtherCAT to do a synchronization of the distributed clock system between different systems. So we have here a setup consisting of two embedded PCs, CX5240, and each of them has an output terminal and timestamp output terminal connected, and also the two systems are connected via an EtherCAT bridge terminal, EL6695.
Okay, so 200% identical setups.
Exactly.
Now, synchronized, but what do you mean with synchronization? So what can we see, what level of synchronization do we reach?
Yeah, so these two timestamp output terminals are generating a pulse signal every 100 milliseconds, and we take a closer look to the oscilloscope, then we see right now we have on the x-axis a time scale of 80 nanoseconds per division. And we can see that the both edges of the signals are in this area, so in 80 nanoseconds of synchronization.
All right, let's. I'd like to challenge you, Karsten.
Yes.
What happens if I pull the synchronization, the EtherCAT cable?
So then the synchronization will get lost. Yeah, of course, you can do it. And then we should see that both of the systems will drift apart over the time. So maybe faster, maybe slower, depending on the state of the synchronization. But now we can see that the edges are drifting apart, and that will continue over the time. So the distributed clocks will completely shift apart completely.
Okay, so this will be a big time shift then.
Yes, of course, over the time, and it goes on and on. Yeah.
Okay, let's put it back in.
Yeah.
Now, this is easy with the next setup. Now we are back synchronized.
Yeah.
Now, is this something very special? Is this a new technology, requires this special terminals? How is this realized?
Yeah. So it's not new, not old, because we are using the underlying technology here is the synchronization method of an EtherCAT. This is in the specification since the beginning of EtherCAT, but over the time we have developed now and then some terminals to make this feature useful or to make it usable. Yeah. So with the EtherCAT bridge terminal, for example, also with an EL6688, which uses the precision time protocol, for example, and also very new, the GNSS terminal, which can be used to synchronize the distributed clock to the satellite systems of the global positioning system.
So I take my existing terminal block, more or less, I plug in this terminal, and then synchronization is realized. This is really easy. But what is the use case for this technology?
Yeah, there are different use cases. For example, the aviation obstruction lights of wind turbines, for example. Also, radio telescopes around the world can be synchronized to build one big telescope. And also in test bench setups, it's very useful to synchronize the clocks to get an accurate measurement of different signals.
I can see you listening, said, oh yeah, I got this, all the wind parks in my backyard and I got 10 radio telescopes, I need that. This is very special, Karsten. What is the down-to-earth application?
Yeah, also in the normal machine building application, we have applications where it is very useful to get an real-time data exchange between systems and also synchronize the two systems together. For example, if you want to scope or to record data, for example, the TwinCAT scope, at the same time from different systems. Then you need to synchronize the clocks to get an accurate measurement.
Okay. Now, 80 nanoseconds is top notch. So what is then the real synchronization? So what times are really happening on the machine normally?
Yeah. So it depends a little bit on the application. In the field, we see the requirements between low microseconds up to 10 milliseconds, requirements on the application side. And what we can achieve with our products, it depends a little bit on the setup, what type of product we are using. This is a very ideal setup with the 80 nanoseconds, and we can achieve at the maximum 10 microseconds of synchronization.
Okay. Well, I think that's so cool that by the development of EtherCAT in 2003, we already thought about these technologies, and just by adding a terminal, we make it happen now to everybody around the world.
Yeah.
Well, this is great.
Absolutely perfect.
Thank you, Karsten. So excited.